town and tell the people.
Hey, I just wanted to stop everything for a second and say how much I'm proud of this community. What this community has become. 30 years. It boggles my mind. Oh, but it's amazing.
Opening for Fugazi, that was like, you know,
yeah,
huge. So that was, I was like, that it would be the greatest launch for our band. I'll be in the band, but I don't want to be called the Fish Hippos.
I can check out every city, and there's lots of great cities, but Omaha, really pretty cool. There's good energy, good people.
We had to make our own fun, and music was something we all had passions about, and you know, a strong work ethic. We wanted to work together and learn from each other, so it was just inevitable that we would form a band.
They played over there.
Terry is Nick Hexum's dad. He had no problem with 311 banging away for hours in the family's basement.
We did these New Music Mondays at the Ranch Bowl. That's where we really kind of developed our chops, was playing every Monday and playing around the bars. I got the funk on the two. I got the funk on the two. Pick it up. Our second album was called Unity, which actually made it to CD, which at the time was unheard of, to have a band from Omaha that actually made a CD, because it was such a new, shiny thing.
You know, Omaha was great in that there was that energy that gave us some drive to do it.
We moved from Omaha to Los Angeles in 92, but the truth is, we got signed from the demos we had done in Omaha. So we thought we need to move out to the big city, but the truth is that it didn't matter.
We just kept working and working and working. I think as long as you're just true to what you're doing, that it's just a matter of time, the energy you put in, get out of it.
Eddie Offord was on our doorstep when we came to our house the day we moved in, so it was legendary for us.
Was one, a really big memory for me was right when that song came out, listen to K-Rock all the time, and then Tammy Heidi plays You Right. She was like, that's a band called 311. They're from Omaha. We've got to all move to Omaha so we can sound like that band. It was like, yes.
What's been the low point of the last year?
Jumping through the flames. Losing everything we owned.
It was like a cleansing to our souls.
But that was like something that was like an obstacle that we jumped over and landed on higher ground. We were like, this means we have to fucking conquer. And we have to, I mean, we're just gonna make it now.
We're gonna tell everybody at once. They'll be saying, why'd you cut your hair off? Because it burned off yesterday in a fire. And to all my friends, it's not the end. The flames ain't swallowed me yet.
It was incredible, but now we've got all new shit, new clothes, you know, we're just, it didn't even faze us, really.
This is our first time in this fair city, Chicago.
You could have a little jam right now.
Hello,
you could have a little jam.
You
could
have a little jam, more of a lot of jam.
There was a time on Grassroots, our second album, where we actually got rid of our home and we just lived on the road.
So the new album is out July 12th, and what's it called?
Grassroots.
Describes how we like to keep everything as a do-it-yourself approach. Now we don't leave anything up to anybody. We do everything ourselves.
We refer to the old days as the chicken and light beer only days. So back in the chicken and light beer only days, we were just happy to be playing shows, you know, and have a string of shows to look forward to.
You know, we had been putting in a lot of work on the road, and these songs on that album were real strong. Every band that breaks through has that one moment, and that was that moment when, you know, yeah, the gates just kind of blew open.
What resonates with me is like Ron Saint and the overall where we're at as a band and making that record. It felt good when we made it, but I don't think we knew that it was going to do as well as it did.
Ago, we were moving from Omaha to LA to get a record contract, and we stopped right here, and the place was open. We stood on this stage and said, one day we're gonna fucking rock this place. Thanks so much for making it possible. Thanks a lot, people.
Then we also went on the Horde tour, which is the hippie tour. We had the Warp tour, which is the punk tour. And we had the Cypress Hill tour, which was the rap tour. We're the only band that could fit in with those
right.
Four different scenes.
That Kiss show was just mind-blowing because those dudes are all in makeup and there's all these bright lights and humongous sound.
We got booed less than most of the openers that opened for Kiss.
You've got to trust your instincts.
Feeling that our next guests are here to blow the roof off the dump. Am I right, boys?
Next time.
dark. You don't know what to do. Next thing you turn around and find a person is you. Thought a thing might be the thing, but the first could be the last. So just get off of your ass. If you want more peace for your butt, there's no love. Understand.
311 with Transistor, and it's pretty weird, but give it a shot. You know, it's not your standard rock music, but there's enough of that.
In a mix, from the grassroots, so big up to our friends. Every crew, every click, and every posse. Big up to all the heads, not of hypocrisy.
Alternative news, you know, especially like SA and I are really into the Coast to Coast radio show with Art Bell. A lot of that stuff comes from just what we are influenced by, really. And so it's more of, you know, just being open-minded.
Whoa, prisoner, my pretty. Whoa,
Beautiful Disaster was the first song written for Transistor. I was kind of having a block during the Blue album. I didn't know what I wanted to write, and then that was the first song that came out. I toured a lot with the band The Urge, and The Urge always started their songs with like these dual or triple harmony horn lead. Yeah. And so I was like, you know what, we can do that with guitar.
Smooth can be, besides living in tents.
Our drummer Chad was going for a catch with the rugby ball and broke this little snuff box bone, they call it.
So he's filling in.
Our good friend Josh Fries
from the Vandals.
Original, you got your gum original. You got your gum original.
come original. All entertainers come original. You got to come original. You got to come original. All entertainer.
The sound system refers to our little system we got here in 311, and just refers to making music, and I think it's perfect.
Sound system is what 311 is. We are a traveling sound system. We come to your town, we set up our speakers, and we rock the house. And that's what we plan on bringing on this album as well.
All right, let's get started.
Come on, here.
Come on, come on now.
Come on,
come on.
I don't know.
All right.
What about, let's go.
Let's go. Come on.
And I don't get this one now.
Slow down.
Get out the way. All right.
Here you go. Keep going.
Is it true?
Yes.
All right. Center in the big light device. All right.
That's great.
All right, I'm going to need 10 cc's of something or other.
Tick, 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 the clock clutches your mind. Endlessly we play and dump that one guy. Go waste another burpee for you today.
I love Japan. Japan's one of my top spots to visit.
The shows are a lot of fun because everyone's bouncing together.
They're banging their heads and, you know, and they're just singing along. They know what they're saying, or if they're singing along the melody.
Decided to call the mayor. We had Mayor Mark Morial officially proclaimed today, March 11th, 2311 day.
So, yo, 47 songs. Here we go.
47.
Hang in there.
Get them all in. All in, we're gonna win. Check it out. Yeah, y'all, come on. Here we go.
Is that a camera?
Can we play now?
It's a great place. It's a cool place for us to rehearse and, you know, shoot some hoops in the parking lot and record some of our record there.
The moment's running down the mountain. It can't be captured from a fountain. That's all that it can be. Absence of agony. Pleasure from the lack of pain. You will be immortal.
Hit
was hanging around Shaq a little bit because he loved music and he wanted to do like a rap song, but he wanted to rock. So we were like, yeah, well, let's go ahead and do it.
What's going on, people? I feel like getting psycho. I feel like getting psycho. Do not try this at home. Kids, do not try this at home. I feel like getting psycho. Everybody jump when I get started. Yo.
When I announced him, the place went crazy. He had this like sweatshirt. He was like, tear off my sweatshirt as soon as we start. Grab the collar and just rip it off his body. And he's wearing just these overalls. We rip into the song Psycho. Place goes completely crazy. He dives into the crowd, smashes his face. He's got a mouthful of blood.
Nailed it, baby.
Yeah. Woo.
Shaq tore it up.
I just want to thank 311 for making my rock dream come true.
Waiting for Shaq. Wouldn't say that to his face.
From Chaos Comes Clarity has been something that I've always embraced, of experiencing a lot of things, but being careful to make sure you make it through to learn the lessons from them.
Pretty much what they represent, skateboarding. I mean, for the people that don't see it, hey, we love 311. There's no doubt. 311.
311. This is an Happy Roots. Big V, what the deal is. Ever since the start of this tour, I ain't know much about them, but now I'll never forget.
Not only are they very handsome looking gentlemen with nice tattoos and haircuts, but they also play their instruments very well. They're one of the best bands to see live ever.
Exactly. And I think that they won't realize how many songs they know. You know what I mean?
Right, exactly.
They don't realize they're 311
they
songs.
Right.
Yeah, like,
exactly.
Oh, I know that song. I like that song. I never knew that was 311.
311 is dope. Chad is sick. Nick is, like, ultra creative. I think that's an Aries thing.
This last album from Chaos, it seems like the stock market. People were going crazy when it came out, so all your old school fans had it. And then it kind of tapered off a little bit, played a couple songs, then you release Amber as the single, and all these people, they were like, what's this 311 about?
It's getting us exposed to a whole new set of people, because
It's not a rap rock song, and people thought we are just a rap rock band. With that, you know, the whoa, it's got right. It just sticks in people's heads.
And it's stuck in mine. I love that song.
It has a lot of emotion behind it. You know, it was coming at a time in my life when, you know, it's a love song. It's really from the heart, and you, people can tell that. People can pick up on that, and you can't fabricate that type of feeling.
Our band is one that kind of changes up its sound and keeps evolving.
Evolver seems to be a pretty accurate, you know, description of what we're doing on this record.
The real star of our video is, of course, our fans, who are going to make it that much more personal. That's been the thing that's kind of been missing from 311 videos, is our personal touch.
Performing the smash hit Love Song from the 51st Date soundtrack. Please welcome
311.
Mm-hmm.
Please welcome 311!
311!
think that's what's so good about us, is we're consistent in our being experimental. So we're constantly being ourselves, and
we're drawing from everything that we've learned throughout traveling and being together, and just everything we've shared.
Don't tread on us, because, you know, we're here to stay.
Being a biannual event, it's like this two-year cycle, you know, that comes around. The electricity, the love, dude, it is overwhelming for everybody.
Other bands could feel this, like, okay. Almost feel guilty that it's so, it's such a great thing, like people gathering from all over the country coming to celebrate being together and this kind of music and us specifically. It's really cool.
We don't feel like the band ends at the front of the stage. It's more of just like a whole happening between us and the fans. Totally different thing depending on the vibe of the crowd. So we're still just really loving it like we did on our first year. It's a fortunate place to be.
people that are happy, people that are positive. You know, and we're just so fortunate to have that group of fans that are like that, because that was our dream, is to be able to bring people together through music in a happy, positive manner, a happy, celebrational sort of vibe. In a week of Saturdays, never knew
I had it so good. It's a unique experience that night, because that's what it's all about, is that moment. There'll be nothing else like it ever again.
We had a good old time touring with Snoop back in 08, and he got really into the unity and the vibe of the 311 tour, and it was really good match.
We're a physical band, we like to move around. We're a band in motion, and we like our fans to be the same way.
When I'm describing it to friends, they're like, how's the new record sound? I'm like, big arena rock. So there's some hugeness that we've never accomplished before.
Welcome to 2009. If you don't come new, then you might get dropped. I think it's strange, the thing is saying, carry on, see the rage, so that when they call, we'll be gone. With the touch of my wand, you are my god, you're my guardian. I hit the jackpot, I'm the lucky one. My fortune endless, never coming undone. Moving, I'm a nomad. Another girl's a boy, so the noise is rad. The treasure is sold, aren't you glad? I get psychedelic with a pen and a pad.
Blue, green, green, red.
No.
Blue, blue, green. What do you mean, no?
No, it starts on green. Press green.
It's a song about music, so it seemed like it was apt to be the first single. And it's fun to play, people dig it. It's a good kind of reintroduction.
Come down 311, mash up the place. 311, 311, 311, 311, 311.
Three Eleven Day, I think, is the culmination of like the absolute best moment for the band. I think it's going to be the highlight of our career so far, and that's the ultimate high.
Nothing like having the most diehard of diehard fans out on the water, getting away from everything, and just enjoying their favorite band in a terribly unique environment. Let's light the fuse quick
and see just what. See that out there? You can see where we're at?
Oh, yeah.
That just happened. Let's just
get crazy with it.
Oh, it's so nice.
Nice, yeah. LQ. Yeah. It's so nice. In my friend.
That's the best welcome to any country we can have as entertainers, to know that people have been listening to our music for decades and they want to see us play live. Where would we be
without the wild nights? I was really excited by the output of love from the people, and everyone was dancing, and also just Brazilian people in general are so affectionate. It's pretty cool, so we're hoping to experience some of that love today.
Say goodbye to the sun, it takes a better turn. Wake up, it's not your typical rehash. Something unpredictable, do you really know that? I will remember this one. I'm just on your momentum. Rock out and break up your own suppression. Like to see you having fun in the setting sun. Sunset in July. Rockers by my side and time is flying by. Watching you dancing and having the time of your life. And it's getting me high. Time is flying by.
Just a continuum of as we keep evolving and exploring, and I always wonder where we're going to go next. People mm-hmm. say, I can't wait to hear where you guys go, and I go, yeah, me too, you know, because it's a collaborative effort. It's part of the journey. It's fun. Introduce you to the excitable crew. This is just how we do. Take it like a time bomb. Watch me go off. 2,000 people having the time of their life. This time I got caught up in it, so I dressed up in costume and got to like really blend and experience the 311 fan base from the other side, which was really amazing. It was just a really welcoming, fun crowd, so it was really cool to get that perspective.
Top, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
That was one of the cool things about the recording process is we had a definite deadline.
Plenty of time to do
it. It got real short, real fast.
Yeah.
And I think the pressure worked for us.
You know, it's just a combination of both future, vintage 311. And that's, I'm just, you know, proud to make that type of record for the fans this time, man. Stoked. There's nothing left to say. You've already got it, and we've said it all. The story never ends. In search of something. But once we arrive, it all starts again. Reaching for higher ground.
A living organism, and you go through these cycles of expanding and contracting and getting more adventurous, and then going through a cycle of getting back to basics a little bit.
It's always ground to cover. That's just it, man. We're always learning. I'm always learning. If you're not learning, then you're not living. There's always something to explore.
Oh man, we had a great time. I mean, all the cruises that we do are unique experiences for the band and band alike. Past one, we went to Jamaica, and magical, beautiful place. I mean, there's really not much more you can say about it. Been humming a high note, maybe something that I wrote, out sailing in my boat. I'm not really sure, I'm still singing the same tune. Been kicking around since June. All morning and afternoon, now it's all a blur. I've been listening to seashells, to hear the stories that they tell, of high times and tide swells.
You know, we're going strong. I wouldn't be surprised if we're only at our halfway point.
It never gets easy, and that's the fun. In a matter of speaking, comes around like the sun. It's a backlash. A backlash, backlash. I reserve judgment to pick through the trash of artists. They didn't get the pop, digging through the bins at the record shop.
Buenas noches, Monterrey, how you feeling?
Oh shit, don't. Those who can't do it surely fucking will. And those who can't thumb, I try to teach that skill. Those who can't teach, know they'll never rise above the sweetness that they criticize.
If someone enjoys your art, that's a reason to live. And if you gotta give, then you know that you gotta give. If someone digs your heart, that's a reason to live. And if you gotta give, then you know that you gotta give.
Believe that, are you with that? The contact, getting
they twist the effects. Is the ever-present Swami and like the elusive Yanni mixes scotch with sake.
That's all I want. Looking for a song to stop me. And on down the trickle flow is Roger's Blunt Party.
Our main story tonight concerns credit reports. The basis for the single most important three-digit number in your whole life, other than, of course, 311, the Beatles of rap rock.
Touring is a mind state. You know, you're on the bus, you get a couple shows on your belt, and then it's just on. You really get into a zone, and it's like a focus.
The fact that the coolest fans can gather out on a cruise ship and totally take it up a notch and totally have fun and totally want everyone else to have as much fun as they're having is an amazing thing. We're very fortunate that we have the fans that we do, because everyone is there for the same reason too.
Still in the sky, cause there's a better place to be, and it's one you need to see in this lifetime. So get on board and be on your way. Whoa, space to fill, nothing to do but chill.
The spirit on this album has been groundbreaking. That's what we wanted to do, is make sure we're going into new territory and not repeating ourselves. And that was kind of the touchstone to see if a song would make it, if it felt new.
At this point, we're a picture that's made up of the family that is our band, but also our fans.
Focus on the empty, getting underneath my skin. How do I keep it? Time flies, burning daylight to the ground. Wash away the ashes, gonna quiet my head down. How do I keep it? How do I keep it here? Cause I wanna get high, but you're keeping me low. I don't got time to waste, time to kill. I've had too much to think.
I feel like all this momentum and the really high morale is happening among the band, because we're just so excited about the new record. And that comes through on the performances. It feels like an exciting new chapter for us. So I think it comes through in live shows.
Try to keep the light within. Avoid another battle.
Realization that, oh my God, what we're doing is actually helping. Like, this isn't just me wanting to be a drummer in a rock band. This actually does something for somebody. That was always an important thing. Well, we have to be here for some of these people. It's a huge motivator. And at this point, you know, I'd say the band's relationship is at an all-time high. We talk about the fans every time we talk about our music. Every time we talk about our record, we talk about our fans. You know, it's totally connected. It is totally a motivation for us to be there. You know, that's kind of a driving force behind us now, because we feel like we can't leave anyone hanging. it's a really cool relationship, and that's why, you know, you say it's 311 for you. I say, well, at this point, it's all of us in this together, for sure.
As I walk through the valley of the shadow of LA, see the faces of the people as they run away. It's a permanent distraction, a modern reaction. The people don't have to feel the dissatisfaction. It's a slow journey up, but a quick ride on down. And nobody here knowing their way around. From the top of the world, every which way is down. And who's gonna take the crown? Achieve a new heights of the day. Circumvent the limits, come through disarray. Greater ascension, cause I was born to elevate. Never having one to be cast away. We go on stronger, taking it along the way. I got the super OG and the ghost drain ace. It's an extension that's reaching so far away. Now we just break it off.
Anything can happen. Time travel. Dimension portals can open. Anything can happen.
Yeah, I'm just thankful all those people are here and we get to have a good time.
Because it really plays, ask me that you wouldn't have it any other way. Deep inside the reaches of the entangled mind, I find a place where I can go where no one ever will find. I make a perfect exchange, I'm making connections strange. Sometimes the places that I go make people think I'm deranged.
Now we're at 915, guys.
Oh, happy 311 day!
1, 2, 3. Happy 311 day! With a quick wink to the eye, I think you all better get used to staying goodbye.
Names.
311 and The Offspring.
Not the band names, dum-dum. What are your real names?
Peanut and Noodles.
They still doing band names?
Sounds like band names.
Peanut Noodles. That sounds like Thai food. I love me some Thai food.
Some kind of rhythm that we've got with 311 Day on the even years and the Cruise on the odd years. It's just amazing. It's a vacation of a life. It's incredible.
Since we were just watching the movie about us, you could just feel it. Really overwhelming.
Hey, we're at the
premiere for Enlarger Show Detail 3. Let's go in the theater and see how good it is.
The theatrical release thing, to be able to release it on, you know, the same day in 220 theaters all across the country was pretty mind-blowing for a little band from Omaha.
Kind of did a split album like we had done on Mosaic. We also just love doing stuff in-house where we kind of really take our time and do more of this sort of the heavier stuff.
Our fans have always been so encouraging for us to go in as many different directions as we want, so we really kind of indulge that to become even more eclectic and more, you know, broadening our palette was something that we really set out to do.
Sophisticated and modern and poppy and relatively strong for an Amber is also kind of just taking a step forward from the traditional, where the band mixes up styles, the beer is doing the same thing. I mean, it was just meant to be. We work really well together. It's been fun trying it all out along the way. Personally, I wanted something stronger, so that's why we made the Beautiful Disaster, but this is perfect where it's at.
Came up with the concept of 311 Day, you know, us doing like a marathon show, and it's something that's made for the fans, kind of by the fans, because they want to hear the songs that we don't play like on a summer tour.
For me, 311 Day is just, it's like a day of gratitude.
I think it gives us an excuse to kind of celebrate each year, be kind of aware of the fact that we're still playing music together each year when it comes by, and just kind of acknowledge where we're at as a band and friends playing music together.
That was a special experience to be able to dig so deep and actually perform 100 songs over 3 nights. It was the first time we've ever cracked triple digits.
We redefine the mark of what can be done. We blaze it up and now we don't have to run.
Yeah, it's a big family. And you know, when the fans come up to you and it's really emotional a lot of times, and like you were saying, people like, you know, they lean on music for hard times in their lives, and so do we. You know, we're the same. And so it's an understanding, I think, and just, you know, symbiotically it's a give and take, and you know, we feed off of them as much as they feed off of us, honestly. So I mean,
people can just forget about their troubles and be in the music and be with the other people there in the crowd and in the band. And it's just sort of a continuation of the tribal experience that music has always been.
closed out 311 Day by dropping the curtain, and we came out in front of the curtain and did an acoustic version of the song "I'll Be Here a While." So we were just right up next to the band.
And I can't even really put into words how thankful we are, how much this means to us. This is everything. Thank you for being a part of it. And I hope all of your dreams come true, just like you made ours come true.
I just need to get space, so I'll be taking my time.
We would love to be remembered as somebody that brought people together, gave people a source of hope, promoted tolerance. If people can feel uplift for a while when they're experiencing our music, then that is a great calling in life. Three11 wants to thank all of our fans for this amazing and magical 30-year ride that we've all been on together. We're very grateful to be part of this big, positive family that 311 Nation has become.